Z. I'm going to be reselling two of my NES consoles with the brand new, well, not brand new, but pre-owned shells. This one is the Mario Cosmic one. I also have one here. It's the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle one. And I'm going to disconnect the controllers on my console here. The reason why I'm doing this is because of the issues that I'm facing. Well, cosmetic issues with the shell. On this one, the top portion fell apart, the door wasn't closing, and on top of that, plastic is very brittle, like falling apart. So let's go ahead and take the crystal. Unscrew the screw holding in the front loader tray. The reason why I have to remove only this screw is because I removed the other screws recently. This is the lonely screw here. Unfortunately, the other long screw has long since disappeared on the person that had the system previously. So maybe they were trying to fix the other one, then they took the, like, swapped some things around. They thought it was this part, this right here, that was bad. That's after you remove two other screws in here, they're holding down. RF modulator in place. Thankfully, I have a magnetic screwdriver. Yeah. Ah, Jesus Christ. Yes!
tank with a light on it.
Yeah, kind of rub a light on it.
He won't climb out of it, so.
No,
he's
hands are open. Get the hands off, please.
Oh, what's he gonna put? Okay. Matt?
Huh?
Put paper towel at the bottom of the cage for him. Yes, I'll put it on my table and fill it up. Oh, okay, thanks. Yes, Ashton.
Thank you.
you have to take that off the old fish tank cover.
Here, come here, take this light. Take this light. This one gets warm. And just bend it into its cage. That one, that does. That gets warm.
Yeah, he took it. Yeah.
Right, now where the hell is I? Oh, yeah. I don't remember where the heck I was at. Alright, so, we're still getting this last screw. It's over here. Out. It's that way up here. So, get this thing fixed and figure out why the heck my laptop just wants to buffer all the time. Another thing I'm going to do is take the stickers off of the shell here and place them right on the customly painted shells. I know you're going to say it's like playing a band-aid. Actually, never mind. It's just only a metaphor if you're, like, for example, in a car where they say it's like putting a band-aid over an open wound. It's a temporary fix, but it's not permanent. So out with the old, and I think this is already, I think I have to unscrew them. I can't even see in there. Okay, they are screwed in. So I have to get my longevity screwdriver. Figure out where the heck the holes are. There we are. I think I have one more. I'll make sure. One more. I think I have to unscrew all these here. Because there's so many of them in here. Saying funny. There, it's just only the outer shell that's painted over. The plastics. Everything except for the controller ports. Because you can't get paint on those. There's one. There are electrical contacts on those things. And two, it's painful to do that. Thankfully, I know which button's the reset, which one's the power button. On this thing. That's I've used the front loader before. Let's go ahead and get these screws out of here. Hang them on here, just in case. This old cranky shell, that is basically like Donald J. Donald Trump Jr., Eric Trump, and actually all the Trumps. You don't want to crank. But let's not talk about politics here. Is bad enough to talk about anyways. Alrighty.
Sure that you didn't splash your place for area.
Is it still saying it?
No, it's not. Just I was just checking my email to see, if they started a thing up there.
Sir, what thing up again?
The working on cars.
Oh, okay. Nothing about it?
Nothing yet.
Now that's out of the way. Let's go ahead and reinstall this thing. What's up? Getting mixed up here. Okay, so this is dock port number one. Yeah, that one's port number two. Nice, but certainly not yeast. The power and reset button. finished.